Because he just tried to squeeze my testicles.
Deontay kicks and tries to get away as the officer walks him in handcuffs to a police car.
Yep, he punched him.
He's only like 11. He's no older than 12.
Yo, I'm about to send this kid to the hospital.
Well, that is a report from WBAL TV's Kai Reed. It was an exclusive, and it's from a video that shows Baltimore City Police officer subduing a 13-year-old boy and his 11-year-old sister. Several videos were taken of this incident. It happened on Monday. It is under review by Baltimore City Police.
And the mom is present, too.
The mom was present, too. The mom said that the 11-year-old or the 13-year-old is learning disabled,
right,
was in a neighbor's yard searching for his cat.
But it was the neighbor, Robert, that actually called 911. This is a situation where the police just didn't show up for no reason. There was a call made by the neighbor that he felt the 13-year-old might be trying to break into his home. So the police showed up for that reason. So there's a gap, Robert, between that phone call and when the cell phone camera began. So we don't know all what happened between that. We only pick it up from where the mother is standing there. The two children, the daughter, 11, and 13-year-old, are sitting on this wall, so to speak. And then things pick up from there, Robert.
All right, the little boy, Deontay. Is this a case, first of all, of the neighbor overreacting? We've seen a number of cases where police are called on children who are selling water, lemonade stands, that sort of thing.
Well, it could be, but more importantly, Robert,
I think
this is a case, more importantly, though, of a police officer who, by the way, was not by himself. He had other officers present there. You can see them in the video, who, instead of de-escalating a situation, escalated it. You look at the mother, and for whatever reason, the mother may have been, not as appropriate as she would have been, but you have a mother there with two children. In many of our juvenile cases, Robert, you have children with no parents, so
right,
the police have to find out what's going on. So instead of them addressing the 13, 11-year-old, talk with the mother, de-escalate the situation, find out what's going on. You don't have a weapon present, Robert. You don't have an allegation of an assault. All you have is this young 13-year-old maybe in the backyard. So there was no reason in my mind to go to the length and degree that they did. And eventually, they let the 13-year-old boy go.
Did the officer overreact? I mean, the officer was punched in the privates and then, reacted.
Well, you're talking about a kid also, like you just heard, and I don't know this, but the mom said with special needs. He might not even understood all of what the officer was doing as the officer grabbed him, as the officer was trying to restrain him. I once again want to say, you have other officers present. Why didn't another officer step in and say, let's calm this down, let's tone this down? That's one of the big problems, Robert, is we've seen other video where officers complacently stand by and watch their other officer do something that's inappropriate. And I just think in this instance, look at the officer's language. Look at how upset he got in public. I just think there's a lot to this.
All of this is taking place as in federal courts today. There's a status hearing on the consent decree. And one of the things Judge Berdar noted was that interim police commissioner Gary Tuggle has a very difficult job because he's transitional leadership. And
to say the least,
Robert, there won't be real reforms until there's stable leadership.
But also, there has to be accountability. And to the police department's credit, you had the firing yesterday of a police officer who did not take the call. And then you had them have a sting operation on an officer selling oxycodone, working with Baltimore County Police and DEA. So to the police department's credit, they are internally trying to deal with some of their problematic officers.
All right, C4 show back tomorrow, 9 to 1 on WBAL News Radio 1090.